name's Tim, and I'm going to be playing some classical guitar tonight. This is part of an ongoing series with the Madison Classical Guitar Society. So we're having a guitarist come in for the next couple, the last Thursday of the next couple months. And I think the next one will be Leonardo Quintero, who is also a doctoral student at the UW School of Music. I am as well. I'm going to start with one of my favorite etude-esque pieces that I give to a lot of my students. It's an Andantino by Ferdinando Carulli. The next two pieces will be by two of my favorite guitar composers, and both of whom I'll play a larger work by them in the second set. But this next one is Anne Malvina by Johann Caspar Mertz. Thank you. The next one will be a short piece by, I think, my favorite composer for the guitar, Agustin Barrios. He was a Paraguayan composer in the first half of the 20th century. I will end the second set with a longer work by him, but I'm going to play one of his short preludes, the prelude in C minor. Next, I'm going to play two preludes from a set of five preludes by Heitor Villa-Lobos. I'm going to play the fourth prelude and then the first prelude. Thank you. First prelude. So next up is a three-movement work by Mauro Giuliani. It's called Sonata Brilliant. It's a classical sonata, so it's typical sonata form, as you would hear like a Mozart sonata, but less notes because it's a guitar. Thank you. tune. After I tune a little bit. tuning.
Thank you.
more for this half and then take a break and finish my beer. And stand under an AC vent. This is a more modern piece. It's by a Russian composer, Sergei Rudnov. And it's based on a Russian folk tune. And the folk tune's kind of a bummer. Someone dies. But it's a really beautiful piece. It's called Old Lime Tree. Thank you.
Thank you.
7 to 9?
7 to 9.
Nice. To get started for the second set. I'm going to start with a collection of random pieces composed by French composers. I think they sound nice together, so I play them together. The first one is Nocturne No. 1 by Erik Satie, and then I'll play a saraband dedicated to a guitarist named Ida Presti, composed by Francis Poulenc. And then I'm going to play The Girl with the Flaxen Hair by Claude Debussy. Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm going to play two pieces by composer Rodrigo. I'm going to play Tiento Antiquo, followed by En Los Trigales. I'm going to move my phone somewhere else in the process. Thank you. and Las Trigalas. Next, I'm going to play a longer work by a composer I played earlier tonight. I played Anne Malvina by Johann Caspar Mertz, a Hungarian composer, and now I'm going to play his piece titled The Elegy. Oh, I think he died in 1856.
30 years old.
Yeah, so he was born in like the early 1800s. I'm going to play another modern thingy, modern-ish. The guy's still alive. I count that as modern. A lot of the guys I play are no longer alive. This is the first movement of a sonatina composed for another very famous guitarist. David Russell is the guitarist that it was composed for. The composer is Jorge Morel, and it's three movements. I'm only going to play the first because I think it's cool. Should have been tuning when I was talking, because this has been a different tuning. First movement of the Morel Sonatina. Thank you. I'm going to play one Bach prelude, and then I'll end with one other piece after that. I'm going to play the prelude to the Prelude Fugue in Allegro, BWV 998. With another piece by another composer I played earlier. It's called La Cathedrale. It's three movements. My roommate just laughed at me because I don't know how to pronounce it. The Cathedrale. It's by Agustin Barrios. He was a Paraguayan composer from the first half of the 20th century. It's in three movements, and the three movements are meant to evoke sort of feelings he had in and around the cathedral and the town square. So the first movement is meant to mimic church bells. The middle movement is meant to mimic hearing a choir rehearse from afar. And then the third movement is meant to evoke leaving the cathedral and entering the busy market square on a Sunday. Next place the Guitar Society will be is Blue Mountain State Park this Saturday from 7 to 9. It'll be me, the president, Chris Allen, and one of our other members putting a concert there. So if you want to be bored, if you're bored and want to be in nature, we're going to play guitar there. Thanks for coming, everyone, by the way. This was a pleasure.